Hey everyone, Nick here with No Ideas Media, and in this week's video, we've got a real live conspiracy to dive into. The video today is brought to you by Devlo Roto Mud Scrapers, which is probably one of the most ingenious farming gadgets that I've ever come across. If muddy packer wheels are causing you grief on your farm, this is the product you've been waiting for. Free shipping if you mention No Ideas Media at purchase too. Link in the description and more about all that at the end of the video. All right, it's conspiracy time. Put on your tinfoil hat and join me, but shut up about it, okay? We're going deep on this one. Summer 2017. A weed-ridden stretch of road accessing an oil gas lease is scheduled to be sprayed with glyphosate by a contract sprayer. Contract sprayers are often hired to maintain lease sites, which are scattered all over rural Alberta. Spraying glyphosate on lease site roads is typical. It's an effective pesticide that controls all kinds of weeds that are being tracked in and out and just kills them dead. But when some wheat plants that were along the road didn't die after a glyphosate application, which they absolutely should have, the contractor got in touch with the authorities. So the government of Alberta examined this surviving wheat and discovered it was herbicide tolerant, Roundup Ready, genetically engineered. This is a real big deal since there is no GE wheat on the market. Now, GE wheat has been field tested in the past, but it's never been put through the regulatory process to get approved for production in the US or Canada. The Canadian Food Inspection Agency conducts an in-depth investigation and uncovers some weirdness. The offending GE wheat contained the same Roundup Ready gene called MON 71200 that was being tested by Monsanto back in the late 90s, early 2000s. But here's the kicker. Those tests were conducted at least 180 miles away from where this sample was found. For reference, farmland here is broken up into mile-by-mile squares called sections. So this wheat was found 180 sections away from its closest known location. If that wasn't enough of a mystery for you, the genetics of this mystery wheat don't fit in a Canadian context. It doesn't match any of the 450 registered varieties of wheat, or for that matter, any other wheat that the CFIA agents were aware of. Its origin was unknown. So, running hypotheticals, the CFIA wondered if this wheat could have possibly escaped some field trial almost 20 years ago and somehow just survived in the wild for almost 2 decades in a variety of wheat they didn't know existed. Not likely. Now, the registered trials with MON 71200 wheat were like finished by 2000. Monsanto was moving to newer, better, faster, stronger Roundup Ready genes, so this mystery wheat was either stored somewhere or was just kicking it in the wild for nearly 20 years before it was randomly discovered by a contract sprayer on a lease road in the middle of nowhere in Alberta and impossibly far distance from any known plots. WTF, if it's hanging out in the wild and traversing great distances, you'd expect to be able to work backwards along its traveled path and find remnants of its indiscriminate breeding with other wheat. But the CFIA, in all 170,000 samples of wheat it examined, found precisely 0 samples that contained the MON 71200 gene. The farmer whose land this wheat was found on, he wasn't involved in the field trials 20 years ago. His equipment, his farm buildings, his property, all clean. This gene was present nowhere. So bottom line, like accidental contamination is not looking likely here. So let me ask you again, how did a handful of this unknown variety of wheat end up on a lease road in Alberta? This isn't the first time this has happened in North America either. 2013. Oregon farmer finds a patch of wheat that ends up being GE Roundup Ready. The trait was from a Monsanto field trial, one the farmer wasn't involved in, one that had been canceled 8 years prior. Just like in Canada, this random wheat wasn't the same variety as was being grown on the Oregon farm. And to add to that, the farmer was growing winter wheat, which pollinates at a totally different time of year than the white spring wheat that was used in the trial 8 years prior. Monsanto confirmed that they'd never put the trait in winter wheat. So like a lot of similarities between these cases. In both situations, the farmer and all of his stuff was thoroughly examined and let off the hook. Farmers were not involved here. In the 2013 case, the authorities concluded that the seed ended up in a fallow field by accidental or purposeful mixing of the seed. Purposeful mixing. Done on purpose. Wheat from an unknown origin with an unregulated genetic trait planted in a fallow field on purpose. Why would anyone do that on purpose? Let's look at the consequences and work backwards. In Alberta, Japan and South Korea like threw the book at us. Both export markets for Canadian wheat suspended our shipments for a time. Thankfully, that's over now. The same trade disruptions happened in Oregon too, and in that case, Monsanto ended up fitting the bill to cover the farmers' losses during that trade disruption. I mean, look here, if Sherlock Holmes was a real person and alive right now, he'd say what he's always said. When you've eliminated the impossible, whatever remains, no matter how improbable, must be the truth. So, putting that famous phrase to practice, and given the fact that this wheat could not have originated in the US or Canada, we're left with intentional planting perpetrated by a non-North American source. So question, who benefits from a disruption of US or Canadian wheat? Well, this is an obvious one. I mean, Russia exports the most wheat of any country in the world, and they're well-known international mischief makers where genetic engineering is concerned. But the discovery of GE wheat in Alberta caused an immediate price drop in our wheat prices in Canada. And China is one of our best customers for wheat. Also, Chinese operatives have been convicted for stealing GE traits in the past. China also has the know-how to create a hitherto unknown variety of GE wheat. So, but that doesn't rule out Greenpeace though, or other environmental NGOs. But Greenpeace has a long, sordid history of illegal anti-GMO shenanigans. In 1995, Greenpeace announced that they'd stolen a package of GE rice seed and switched it with non-GE rice for some reason. So, like, there you go. I promised a conspiracy, I delivered. I don't often get to wear my metaphorical tinfoil hat, but today, it kind of felt necessary. And the truth is, we honestly don't know where this wheat came from. And the conclusions made in this video are just conjecture, okay? But it's not conjecture for the sake of itself. We genuinely don't know what happened, and there isn't a logical or easy answer to just explain it away. It's a true mystery, and it's kind of interesting to think about. All right, and thanks again to Devlo Roto Mud Scrapers for sponsoring the video today. Honestly, if you farm, this is a product you should probably just know about. It's such a no-brainer because mud sticking to wheels is not really a small problem. It can really mess up your planting. Devlo Roto Mud Scrapers are an easy-to-install add-on that will literally keep you rolling while your neighbors are standing still. Start seeding earlier in the day and finish later, get in the field more quickly after rain, get in tighter on wet areas, save fuel, and wear out your tires way less quickly than you would with stationary scrapers. Honestly, you should probably just go like check out their website really quick by following the link that's in the description below. And as an added bonus, if you mention No Ideas Media when you make your purchase, you'll get free shipping, which is not a bad deal. Link is on the screen right here and is also below in the description, as I said. Take a peek. And also thanks to Robert Wager for writing the article that inspired this video. Links to that article are also in the video description. Thanks again for watching.